I kind of feel like we're in a hurricane, right, where there's a lot of disruption going on everywhere around us. I didn't know what 98% of it was because I kept my head down. But I felt like I wanted to make sure we stayed in the eye of it and where it's supposed to be calm.
And calm is how athletic director Greg Byrne handled the storms that rolled through the capstone over the past year. Both winds of change. First, finding a new coach to step into the shoes of a legend. Then making history in basketball with the first Final Four run.
It's been great exposure for our program. Kids want to come play here and be a part of it.
We caught up with Byrne in Los Angeles when the Tide cut down the nets to head to the Final Four. The AD has won at every level at football, but basketball, this one, seemed different.
Feels absolutely incredible. I'm so excited for everybody, our kids, our coaches, all of our fans, our university.
With success comes attention. After the Tide's NCAA tournament run, Coach Nate Oates became one of the top names discussed when the head coaching job opened at Kentucky.
I'll tell you, when the news about Coach Calipari going to Arkansas came out, and Nate and I talked quite a bit. He was very transparent with me. You never want a coach to go dark on you during those times. Nate never went dark on me. We effectively communicated the whole time.
Communication was key, especially when Nick Saban decided to call it a coaching career. Byrne explains this move was something he was prepped for every offseason the past few years.
He couldn't have been more transparent with me over the last few years. He's talked about that. He called me, we played in the Rose Bowl on Monday. He called me on Friday at the end of the week when we had come back and he was doing some stuff. And then he called me on Friday and he said, can we talk next week? So we actually sat right there and on Tuesday.
With 7 national titles and 11 SEC championships, Nick Saban retired from coaching.
He knew that we wanted him to keep coaching as long as he physically and mentally wanted to. But at the same time, too, it would have been irresponsible for me not to say this. He also deserved the right to retire.
What was a monumental week for Alabama fans was a race for Byrne. They were on the clock to find the next head coach at Alabama.
I felt strongly we were going to be able to get a great coach. But as you can imagine, we worked a long time to be prepared for this day.
Byrne asked the team to give him 72 hours to find the new head coach on the capstone. He only needed 49 to lock in Kalen DeBoer.
I've studied coaching hires as long as I can remember. But I think it's a mistake when you go say, well, I got to go try to get somebody just like the one who was here before, especially when they're successful.
DeBoer checked all the boxes.
You want to have somebody that respects the person that was there before them and hopefully embraces the person there before them. I think that's healthy for the organization and long-term success. And then also respects the institution. But you also want somebody that's confident in who they are.
For Byrne, being athletic director is much more than sports. He and his wife, Regina, are very involved in the community. In fact, this year, they hosted the first ever sneaker ball, benefiting the Boys and Girls Club. Of course, athletes were involved.
Neil Hibbert, football. Malachi Moore, football.
Back at the capstone, Byrne is ready for a new chapter with new goals. Facilities are going up all over campus. From a new practice facility for golf to refurbishing and expanding Coleman Coliseum. Byrne is committed to making sure the University of Alabama has all the tools needed to win in every sport and continuing the football tradition for years to come.